My dear students, this is your accounting coach ARD, and the topic that we will be going to discuss today is a very easy yet important topic. We need to make T account for transactions. Now, T accounts are basically based on double entry. Now, before going through this exercise, I would strongly recommend that you go through my basic lecture for double entry with the name of double entry revision or double entry concepts. So if you don't know what does a debit means and what does a credit means, and if the asset increase, if it is debited or credited, if you're not sure of that, then there is no point of exercising this transactions. Once, if you have done with double entry concepts, you may proceed to this question. Now, basically, this question is made by me in order to give you the idea of how or what kind of transactions are basically done in a business and what T accounts we need to make them. Firstly, we will be making T accounts with the help of double entry. Then we need to balance off these T accounts at the end of the month, and then after that we need to make a trial balance. So this is one of the most important areas of accounting. It is basically the foundation stone for any accountant. If you are weak in double entry, you will suffer in your later examinations, maybe A levels or any other examination, maybe for professional qualifications if you'll go. So this is the basics of any accounting. So before moving forward, this is a question that we're going to discuss. There are a few number of transactions. So I would suggest you to kindly take a snapshot, a picture of this transaction. It's better if you print it. And if you cannot print it, we just need to make a reference of this in some separate device. So I'm moving forward, but I'll be needing these transactions. You will be needing these transactions. So make a copy of it in the phone before moving forward. Okay, students, let's start. Although I'm assuming that you have gone through my lecture for double entry revision, that is what is debited and what is credited, but to just give you a general idea, AED is the mnemonic that we need to remember. Arab Emirates Dirham, this is a currency for UAE. A stand for asset, E stand for expense, and D stand for drawing. Asset, expense, and drawing, Arab Emirates Dirham, you can remember with this. AED is always debited. Arab Emirates Dirham, asset, expense, and drawing is always debited. Whenever an asset, an expense, or drawing increases, it is always debited. And whenever an asset, expense, and drawing is decreased, it would be reversed. That is, it would be credited. Then LIC, Life Insurance Company. You can remember with this mnemonic, Life Insurance Company. Liability, income, and capital. Whenever these three items increase, these are always credited. So whenever asset expense drawing is increased, it would be debited, and when it would be decreased, it is vice versa, it would be credited. LIC is always increased by credit, and if you need to decrease liability, income, or capital, it would be debited, means opposite, other way around. Now let us start with the example that we just discussed. These are all transactions for December 2018. You need to refer to the question back. On the first, we started the business with $65,000 of cash and $135 in the bank. Now, whenever we are starting the business, the cash and bank is coming into the business. So the cash or bank would be increased. Similarly, on the other hand, our capital is also increasing. So whenever cash or bank is increasing, I'm making all of these T accounts. I need to make two T accounts, one for cash, one for capital, and another one for bank. So whenever cash is coming into the business, cash is an asset. Asset account would be debited. Now this left hand side is a debit side. This right hand side is credit side. These are all debit sides. Left hand side. These are all credit side. Whenever cash is coming into the business, cash would be debited. And the reference that we need to write is capital. What does this mean? This means capital is not debited. Cash is debited with reference of capital. My dear students, the account that is debited will use the reference of the account that is being credited. And whenever capital increase, capital is being credited. So the capital is increasing because of cash. So the account that would be debited would use the reference of the account that would be credited. And the account that would be credited would use the reference of the account that would be debited. So the opposite reference need to be put. So my dear students, if I put cash in a cash account as a reference, that would be wrong. And similarly, if I put capital in the reference of capital account, this would be wrong. Because if you write your name, you would write father's name in front of your name. You may not write Ali, son of Ali. Okay. So you would write your father's name. Similarly, if your father, someone asks your father, who is your son? So he would be telling your name. So you would be using your father's name. And for example, your father will use your name. Okay. So all this example, this is technically not correct. So just for the sake of remember. Okay. So secondly, on the 1st of December, we have also invested bank into the money, bank account into our business. So bank is 135,000. So the bank account would be debited. Again, if the bank is debited, the reference would be the credit transaction would be capital. And if the capital is increased, the reference would be bank. So bank is increasing because of capital and the capital is increasing because of bank. We need to write capital in front of in the bank account as a reference and would be writing bank in the reference of capital. So if I would write bank in the reference of bank, this would be wrong. Again, capital in a capital account as a reference would be wrong. Now let's move to second transaction, which is on 3rd December. Bought a shop for 8,000 from Peter, agreeing to pay him within 8 months. Now if we are buying a shop, shop is basically a building, a premises where we can work. So this is a non-current asset for the business. So there would be a separate account for shop or premises maybe. And there would be another account from Mr. Peter. So Mr. Peter is basically a supplier or the landlord through which from which we have bought his shop. So shop would be debited. Why? An asset always increases with a debit. And because we haven't paid for this shop, we still owe him the money, Mr. Peter. So the reference would be Mr. Peter. So the entry would be, general entry would be shop account would be debited and Peter account would be credited. So if we are debiting shop, the reference would be Peter. And if we are crediting Peter, the reference would be shop. Now thirdly, we have received a loan from James for 50,000 by check. Whenever we are receiving money in the form of loan or whatever form, the bank account would be increased. So the bank account would be increased and there would be a separate loan account. As you know, loan is a liability. So we can write James loan or loan from James would be better. So the money is coming into the business because we need money. Therefore, we took out a loan from Mr. James. So the bank would be debited and the reference would be loan from James. The bank account would be writing the reference of loan from James. And the loan from James account would be credited because a liability always increases when credited. So the loan account would be credited with the reference of bank. So it would be writing again opposite references in the bank account, the loan reference would be there, and in the loan account the reference would be bank. Now the next transaction is bought goods from D'Souza for 3,000, agreeing to pay him later. We have bought goods from D'Souza. Whenever we are buying goods, an account that we'll be using would be of purchases. So the purchase account would always be debited. Why? Because the goods are coming into the business and the asset of stock is increasing. So the purchase account would be debited. And because we haven't paid D'Souza yet, so D'Souza would be our liability, also known as a trade payables. So the purchase would be debited with the reference of Mr. D'Souza. On 9th of December, the dates are also important. And the D'Souza account would be credited with the reference of purchase. So D'Souza is basically a liability for the business. Whenever a liability increases, it is always credited. So purchase with the reference of D'Souza, and D'Souza would be credited with the reference of purchase. Now the next transaction is sold 750 of the goods to Jimmy and receive a promise from him to pay later. We have sold the goods. Whenever the word sold comes in the exam, this means there would be a sales. A sales account would always be credited. Why? because an asset is decreased. Whenever the stock is going out of the business, the asset would be decreased. So the sales account would always be credited. And because we have not yet received the money from Jimmy, and he has just promised us to pay us the money later, so Jimmy would be debited. So that a new account would be opened with the name of Jimmy, and a sales account would also need to be opened. Now I'm moving it forward. So there are two transactions. One is Jimmy and one is sales. So Jimmy account would be debited with the reference of sales because we have sold goods to Jimmy, and a sales account would be credited with the reference of Jimmy because sales is being made to Jimmy. So Jimmy would be debited with the reference of sales and sales would be credited with the reference of Jimmy. Then we have paid insurance by cash. Insurance is an expense. Whenever an expense increases, it is always debited. So the transaction would be insurance would be debited with the reference of cash, and the cash account that we made on the previous page would be credited with the reference of insurance. Then next transaction is on 15th of December when we sublet part of the shop to Hussein for rent of 550 by check. Sublet means we have ourselves got this shop on rent or premises on rent, and then this shop is being rented out to someone else. This means sublet. So whenever we are giving the shop to rent to someone, this rent is our income and the bank is our asset. So bank account would be increased. A bank account would be debited with the reference of rent received, and a new account would be opened with the name of rent received. So whenever we are paying rent, there would be a rent account only or rent payable account, which is an expense account. And whenever we are receiving rent from someone, this would be rent received and income account. So rent received would be credited. Why? Because an income is always increased when credited. So income account would be credited with the reference of bank. Now there is no mention of Hussein in this transaction. Why? Because when we let our premises or shop to Hussein for rent by check, whenever Hussein has paid us the money upfront from in the form of check, so we'd be using a bank account rather than making a Hussein account. Hussein account would be debited when there was a credit transaction. Because it is a cash transaction or check transaction, no need to make a Hussein account. So the entry would be bank account would be debited with the reference of rent received, and a rent received would be credited with the reference of bank. Then the next transaction is sold goods worth 525 in exchange for cash. Now in this question, I've tried to make accounts for all of the normal transactions or the transactions that are being tested in the exam regularly. So all of these transactions, as you may see, are somewhat different. There is no repetition of transactions. All of these transactions are unique in nature. Now we are selling goods in the form of cash, so the sales account would be credited. Now one thing also we need to remember is that one account would be opened once only in each question. So there would be no duplicate accounts, there will be no two sales account, no two cash account, and no two debtor or creditor accounts. So one account would be opened for each category or each title. Okay, so the sales account would be credited because we have received the money upfront in the form of cash. A cash account would be debited in the previous page, and the sales account would be credited. Then we have bought more goods worth 6,000 in exchange of cash. Whenever we are buying goods, there would be a purchase transaction. So whenever we are purchasing goods on cash, the entry would be purchase account would be debited. See, this is a purchase account. Purchase account would be debited, reference would be cash, and similarly a cash account would be credited with the reference of purchase. Why? Because purchase is being debited because the asset is increasing, the asset of stock, and the cash is decreasing. Whenever a cash is decreased and whenever an asset is decreased, it would be credited. Then we have next transaction is repaid part of the loan to James by check. So when we got the loan from James, the entry was bank would be debited and loan would be credited. Now it will be reversed. Because we are paying off our loan, our liability goes down. So the liability loan account would be debited, and so our bank account, because we are repaying the loan through our bank account will also goes down. So the entry would be loan debit, reference of bank, and bank account would be created with the reference of loan from James. So loan is a liability. If the liability is being decreased, it would be debited, and a bank is an asset. Whenever an asset increase, it would be debit, and whenever it is decreased, it would be credited. Now third last transaction is it. Some of the goods worth 250 were defected and returned back to D'Souza. When we are returning goods back to D'Souza, because D'Souza is a supplier, because earlier we purchased goods from D'Souza, it would be return outward transaction, also known as a purchase return. So when we bought goods from D'Souza, our liability increased by 3000, and when we are returning goods back to D'Souza, our liability will be decreased. So the entry would be D'Souza account would be debited, and return outward account, also known as purchase return account, would need to be created. Entry would be D'Souza debit and return outward account needs to be credited. So we'd be making a separate return outward account, and we'll be crediting it with the reference of D'Souza. Then there is another transaction, Jimmy return goods to us. If the Jimmy is returning goods to us, this means this is a return inward transaction. Whenever we are getting goods back from a customer because their goods are no longer required or they are faulty, there would be a return inward transaction. Return inward is also known as sale return. A return inward account should be debited with the reference of Jimmy, and a Jimmy account would be credited with the reference of return inwards. When we sold goods to Jimmy, Jimmy account was debited, and when Jimmy is returning goods back to us, the Jimmy account would be credited, because Jimmy is a customer and asset. An asset increases on debit and an asset decreases on credit, and return inward is being debit. Why? Because the goods are coming into the business and the asset is increasing. And the last transaction is to cash from the bank 500 and goods worth 250 for personal use. Now you may be aware, whenever we are taking something out of the business for personal use or for our home, this is known as a drawings. So whether the drawing is in cash form or check form or goods form, a drawing account is always debited. Why is drawing being debited? First of all, you can remember with AED, asset expense drawing, always debit. So why is drawing being debited? Because drawing decreases our capital. A capital always increases on credit, and if something decreases our capital, this is a contra capital maybe. So drawing is basically decreasing our capital. So drawing would be debit with the reference of bank, and the bank account would be credited. Similarly, we have also taken out goods from the business, because maybe we have a mobile shop, a cell phone shop, and gadgets, we sell gadgets, and one of our phone we need for personal use, so we took phone for our personal use. So drawing would be debited, and what would be credited, because we have not taken cash this time, we have taken out goods from the business, the account would be credited with will be of purchases. Why? Because whenever we are buying goods for the business, mobile phones, maybe if we are dealing with mobile phones, so we use debit the purchase account, and if the goods are taking out of the business, we'll be crediting purchase account. So the entry would be drawing account would be debited and purchase account would be credited. Now let us do the balancing part. All of the transactions we have finished dealing with, all of the transaction. Now let's start balancing one by one. First of all, we have cash account. Now see, there are two sides of a cash account. One is the debit side and another is credit side. Now what I need to do, we need to leave two lines on both of the sides, and we make a total. For totaling, for ruling of account, this is known as rule off. So for ruling of an account, we will be making a single line on the top and two double lines on the bottom. So what we need to do, we need to add up both of these sides. As you can see, the debit side is a greater side. So what we need to do, we need to write the debit side or the greater side on both of the sides. Now the debit side is already 65525. Credit side is much less than 65525. What we need to do, we need to make the credit side also 65525. Now there is a difference between these two values. Now I need to insert a balance which is known as the balance CD. What I will do, I will deduct 6150. The total for these two is 6150. I will deduct 6150 from this balance 65525 in order to arrive a balance CD that is 59375. So this is a closing balance for cash at the end of the year. This means in this month of December, we have received cash into the business worth 65525, and we have out of that amount we have just paid out 6150, and the cash balance that needs to remain at the end of the month is 59375. Now this balance carried down would become a balance brought down at the start of next month. So this 31st December balance becomes 1st January 2019. The next year is there, and this will become balance BD. So the balance BD is an opening balance and balance CD is a closing balance. Now balance CD would come on the lesser side or shorter side, and balance brought down would comes on the greater side. And the balance CD always comes before the totals, and the balance brought down always comes after the totals. Okay, now let's balance other accounts as well. And now if I start balancing a bank account, as you can see, the greater side again is the debit side. So what I need to do, I need to write the greater amount on the both of the sides. Now the debit side was already 18550. We need to make a credit side also 18550. Now in order to do this, I need to insert a figure in this side, the shorter side, which is known as a balance CD. CD stands for carried down, and BD stands for balance brought down. CD is a closing balance and brought down is an opening balance. So if I deduct 10,500, the total for the shorter side is 10,500. If I deduct 10,500 from this, the greater value, the balance that remain in their books is 175050. So this is the bank balance that is remaining in our books at the end of the year or end of the month. So this balance CD becomes balance brought down in the next accounting period. This means at the end of December 2018 and in the start of the subsequent month, next month, that is January 2019, we have bank balance of 175050. Now let's do for capital account. As you can see, there is nothing on the debit side because capital is always credit. There is no transactions on the debit side. So what we need to do, we just need to write this balance, and this becomes a balance CD. Means the shorter side becomes balance CD because there is only one transaction. We do not need to write the total again. We just need to rule off this and just make a double line in underneath that. And this balance carried down becomes balance brought down at the start of next accounting period, that is 1st January. This means we have capital balance 1st January for 200,000. So always the balance that counts is the balance BD. So if I ask you what is the balance for a capital account, you may say, it is a credit balance of 200,000. And if I say what is the balance for a bank, you may say it is a 175050 debit balance, because only that balance BD is that counts, balance CD is never counted. So I must repeat this in all of these accounts. Let's do one more, one for shop. As you may see, there is only one transaction, the shop for 8,000 we purchased the shop. There is no transaction on the credit side, so the credit side becomes the shorter side, which becomes balance CD. Because there is only one transaction, I need not write the total again 8,000, because there only 1,000, only one transaction of 8,000. The total for 8,000 would also be 8,000. So this balance CD or the total becomes balance BD in the next accounting period. This becomes a balance BD. Now what I need to do, I need to repeat this process in all of these. This balance CD becomes balance BD. Again, we have taken 50,000 loan from James. Out of this 50,000, 10,000 we already repaid it. So the balance that remains is 40,000. So the shorter side would become balance CD at the end of the year, and this balance carried down would become balance brought down at the next year. So some students, what they do, they just write BD and CD, which is not acceptable according to the CAIE curriculum. The examiner specifically says that you need to write the full amount, full thing, the balance BD and not just the BD or CD. So this is important if you don't want to lose your easy marks. So again, the debit side is greater for purchases. The short side is balance carried down, which becomes balance brought down in the next accounting period. So I would repeat the same process as you may see. This is easy, so I can skip this part, and we just need to balance all of these T accounts in order to arrive a balance brought down for all of that. And lastly, in this question, what I need to do, I need to make a trial balance. Now, my dear students, what is basically a trial balance? Trial balance is basically a list of all of the balances at a particular date. So I need to make a trial balance at the end of December. Trial balance ensures that your double entry is complete and you have made a credit entry for every debit entry, and the debit and credit sides are both equal. So what I need to do, I need to copy all of the account titles, all of the accounts that I made, cash, bank, capital. I just need to copy all of these. And what I need to do, I just need to write the balance BDs of all of that. I just need to extract the balance brought downs, not the balance carried downs. Although the amount is same, but the side is important. The balance brought down for cash is coming on the debit side. Bank is also coming on the debit side. And the balance for capital is coming on the credit side. Why? Because we have discussed earlier that asset, expense and drawing are always debit. The nature of these is debit. So all of the assets, expenses and drawings, balance brought down would be on the debit side. And all of the liabilities, incomes and capital, the balance brought down would be on the credit side. Because if you see, the capital is balance brought down credit. Then again, Peter is a liability. This is also credit. Loan from James is also credit. So all of the incomes and liabilities would come on the credit side. So what I need to do, I just need to extract the balance BDs, and I just need to remember the sides, where do they belong, whether they belong on the debit side or the credit side. I just need to write all of these balances. All of the T accounts would come on trial balance, whether there are asset, expense or drawing, or whether they are liability, income or capital. So the cash balance brought down is on the debit side, that is 59375. Bank is also on the debit side. Capital always comes on the credit side. Shop is an asset, therefore it's coming on the debit side. Peter is a liability. Loan is a liability. Purchase is debit. Why? Because the goods are coming into the business. The asset is increasing. D'Souza is a liability. Jimmy is an asset. It is a customer. He is a customer. Sales is a credit because goods are going out of the business. Insurance is an expense. Expense is always debited. Rent received is an income. Income is being credited. And return outward is being credited, because the goods are going out of the business. Return inward is debit because goods are coming into the business, and drawing is always debited. So now when I make this trial balance, I just ensure that I need to write this on the appropriate side. The asset, expense and drawing are coming on the debit side, and liability, income and capital are coming on the credit side. So wherever a balance brought down is coming, we just need to write it here. Now at the end of this, we need to balance this trial balance. Now if you make the correct entry for every debit, if you have made a credit, this means the trial balance always balances. And if the trial balance is your balance, you are more than happy than ever. Now, so if you like this video, kindly do share your precious comment, and also tell me from where and which city you are watching this video. Also, do subscribe my channel if you haven't done so already. Thank you.